Ladies and gentlemen, CAW fans worldwide, we are live here tonight from Concord, New Hampshire, as this is the final pit stop on the road to our next mega event, Unbound, live in Montreal, Quebec, Canada. As tonight, we welcome you to episode 21 of the Universal Championship Wrestling League. Hello everyone, this is V-Pac here once again as we are set for an exciting night of action on our last stop before we head to Montreal, Quebec, Canada, which will be the host for UCWL's third mega event, Unbound. And tonight, we got an exciting lineup of action this evening, as tonight, we will see the finale of the Elimination Chase. It's come down to two men, Chef Gordon Ramsay and Kyo Kusanagi. Only one of those two men will challenge Monkey D. Luffy for the UCWL Cyberspace Championship at Unbound. Who will it be? We'll find out later tonight. Also on our last episode, we saw Bebop defeat Captain Britain in one-on-one competition. Now it'll be their respective tag team partners' turn to do battle, as MI13's Union Jack will face off against Rocksteady. Will Rocksteady keep the momentum flowing for his team, or will we see Union Jack pick up a victory here tonight? And in our main event, we will see the UCWL champion, the Green Arrow, in non-title action here tonight as he faces off against the wielder of the Death Note, Light Yagami. Can the champ build some momentum heading into his Triple Threat Championship match at Unbound, or will we see a huge upset here tonight from Light Yagami? But folks, we are kicking things off with some women's action here tonight as Daisy Johnson is in action as she faces off against Faith Connors in a rematch from the Queens of Wrestling Tournament qualifiers. Let's head up to Shao Curtis for the introductions.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your opening contest for this evening, and it is a women's match, and it's set for one fall.
Gentlemen, earlier today, cameras caught up with Daisy Johnson as she had some good news to report to her predecessor, Kendall Morgan. Yeah. Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Daisy Johnson is getting what she wants. It'll be her and her tag team partner, who has not been revealed yet, as they're going to be taking on the team of Bo Dennis and Faith Connors in Unbound. But tonight, Daisy Johnson doesn't have to wait until Unbound, because she's set to go one-on-one with Faith Connors right now.
And her opponent, being accompanied to the ring by Bo Dennis, from Glass City, Faith Connors.
Well, as you can see, ladies and gentlemen, Faith Connors isn't coming alone. Joining her side is Bo Dennis. Of course, the last time Faith Connors went one-on-one with Daisy Johnson, Daisy got the victory. However, afterwards, both Faith and Bo laid her out and put her on the shelf for a little while. This is Daisy Johnson's first matchup since that heinous attack, and she's got a chance to get some payback on Faith Connors here tonight. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen. This match is underway, and it's Daisy Johnson starting off strong with the running bulldog onto Faith Connors. Of course, Daisy's been waiting for several weeks to get her hands on both Bo Dennis and Faith Connors after what went down in the Queens of Wrestling tournament. You could say Bo and Faith were probably the main reason Daisy Johnson didn't make it into the tournament itself. And look at this series of reversals there. Daisy Johnson still in control, but up until that drop kick there from Faith Connors. Now Faith going to the top rope, driving an elbow right into the lower back of Daisy Johnson. Of course, as we mentioned before, it is now confirmed Daisy Johnson and a partner of her choosing will be facing off against the team of Faith Connors and Bo Dennis at Unbound. And oh, Daisy went for an elbow of her own, but Faith Connors was able to avoid it. And now Connors into the ropes goes Daisy and hits her with a Luthes press. And oh, Jesus. Look at this. Just slamming the back of Daisy Johnson's head into the canvas. Now look at this. Oh, we've seen these before from Faith Connors. These multiple kicks followed by the roundhouse to the face. And now Faith Connors. No, look at this. Daisy sweeping the legs. Daisy, though, missing with the kick. Now look at this. Oh, what a pump handle backbreaker from Faith Connors. Now Faith. Oh, look at that. The moon stomp right off the bat. And this could be it right here for Daisy. The cover. Two. And no. Very surprising to see Faith Connors attempt the moon stomp very early into this matchup. Oh, she may be going for it again. She's on the top rope. Oh, this time it goes with a corkscrew senton. Now trying to choke the life out of Daisy. And you see at the bottom of your screen, Bo Dennis. Loving every second of it. There's a spinning roundhouse kick. Here's the cover. Two and oh. Daisy Johnson still able to hang on. Look at the right hand to the face. Faith Connors counters it. And now it's Daisy with the elbows. Front face lock applied there by Faith Connors. Daisy was able to escape out of it, but gets caught with the arm drag. Fireman's carry there from Daisy Johnson. And now Daisy throwing Faith into the ropes. Irish whip, no. Forearm there. And Daisy Johnson with the rebound, Lariat. Oh, wait a minute. Bo Dennis is on the ring apron. Bo Dennis on the ring apron trying to distract Daisy, but Daisy not even paying attention to her. However, it allows Faith Connors to get back in control, and here we go again. More of those kicks. Followed by the roundhouse. Below this, Daisy back in control with the arm drag. And now slamming the back of Faith Connors' head into the canvas. Could be measuring her. Look at this. By the way, she finally has a name for that move. She calls that the Aftershock 2 and no. Only a two count after the Aftershock. Look at this, now into the ropes. Huge heel kick there. And another drop, and a drop kick. And a sweet neck breaker. Look at this now, though. Faith Connors sweeping the legs. And now measuring Daisy Johnson. Look at this now. No. Counter there by Daisy into the dragon screw. Faith Connors now hits the jawbreaker. And a sit down spine buster into the cover. Two. And no. Only a two count. Faith Connors continuing to go to work on Daisy. Now Daisy coming back with the uppercut. And a flatliner. But look at this again. Bo Dennis on the ring apron. This time Daisy's getting back in her face. Daisy needs to pay attention to Faith Connors. Oh, here we go. Look at this. Another aftershock. This could do it right here. Two. Oh, wait a minute. I can't tell what just happened. I can't tell if Faith kicked out of that move or if Bo Dennis distracted the referee. And Daisy's not pleased with it, but there you see a left hand from Faith Connors. Daisy escapes the backbreaker attempt. And hits a sidewalk slam. Both ladies are down though. Who's going to get to their feet first here? And it looks like it's Daisy. Yeah, Daisy, look at this, going for the cover. One, two, and no. Daisy Johnson back to her feet. Must counter there by Faith Connors. And up, Daisy lands on her feet. German suplex. Daisy Johnson in control of this matchup. Huge axe handle to the back of Faith Connors. And look at this again, getting in the face of Bo Dennis. Daisy needs to focus on her opponent here. But again, she's... It allows Faith Connors to get back in control with the Tilt-A-Whirl flying head scissors. Faith Connors now. And another roundhouse kick. But look at this, Daisy. Back to her feet. Are we gonna see it again? Here we go. A third aftershock. And that's gotta do it. One, two, no. I can't believe it. That's three aftershocks that Faith Connors has kicked out of. And now Faith Connors with the jawbreaker. Went for the drop kick. But Daisy saw it coming. Snapmare takeover. And now it's Daisy wrenching on the neck trying to wear down Faith Connors. Bliss turns her around. Nope. Faith Connors reverses. This has been a back and forth encounter. And there's the roundhouse kick. Roundhouse kick found the money. Is this going to be in for Daisy Johnson? Two and no. And let's not forget, right now, Daisy may be out here by herself, but come Unbound, she will have a tag team partner. Look at this. Faith Connors measuring Daisy off the top rope with the flying martial arts kick. And now, Faith Connors going to work on Daisy Johnson with the leg drop. And now, again with the roundhouse kick. But this time, it's Daisy with the jawbreaker. And this time it's Faith Connors who escapes the backbreaker attempt. But down to the canvas goes Daisy Johnson with that wrist clutch drop toe hold. And there's another roundhouse kick. And now, Faith Connors trying to wear down the legs of Daisy Johnson. And now, Faith Connors. No, reversal by Daisy. Knee to the chest there. Daisy trying to get this crowd fired up here. Oh, look at that huge headbutt to the top of Faith Connors' head there. Now look at this, spinning back kick, into the ropes, drop kick, and another one. And the swinging neck breaker. Daisy Johnson on fire here. Well, look at this now. Faith Connors counters with the dragon screw leg whip. And again, wasting too much time trying to taunt the fans. And now Faith Connors, no, Daisy reverses. A kick to the midsection there by Daisy. Oh wait, forearm, oh here we go again. Another rebound lariat. Rebound lariat on the money. Here's the cover. Two and no. Again, Faith Connors will not stay down. But neither will Daisy. Arm drag take over. No. Punch to the face there by Faith Connors. Went for the slam reversal there. And now Daisy. Here we go. A fourth aftershock. An aftershock. One. Two. Oh, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? That is four aftershocks. Daisy Johnson is hitting this matchup, and somehow Faith Connors has managed to kick out of all four of them. And now Faith Connors back in control. And look at that, slapping the taste out of Daisy Johnson's mouth. And I get it with the roundhouse. This has been a hell of a match between both these ladies. Daisy Johnson with the uppercut. And another sidewalk slam. And now Daisy trying to get herself fired up here. Trying to get the crowd rally behind her. Look at that though. Jawbreaker there by Faith. Reversal by Daisy. And a huge knee to the face. Look at Daisy Johnson go to work. Turns her around. Backdrop suplex. And Bo Dennis looks like she's starting to worry a little bit here. Daisy Johnson. Oh! I think she was trying to go for the shockwave strike. But instead hits a fifth aftershock. One, two, and no! I cannot believe it. I mean, I got to give credit where credit is due. Faith Connors is one tough competitor to kick out of five of those aftershock DDTs. And now, oh wait, another roundhouse kick. Here's the cover. Two. And no. Let's not take anything away from Daisy Johnson either. She's a tough competitor. She's kicked out of, I don't know how many of those roundhouse kicks. Daisy Johnson now, second rope. What she got planned here? Daisy Johnson with the axe handle. Oh no, huge kick to the head there. Now Faith Connors chucking Daisy Johnson. Oh, I think Faith is gonna fly. Faith Connors off the ropes. Huge somersault plotch onto the floor there. Or a tope called Hilo. Or is it Konjiro? I always get the two mixed up. Daisy Johnson now. Somehow back in control of this matchup. And a huge headbutt to the midsection. Daisy Johnson now. Bringing Faith Connors to her feet. Huge suplex. What a way to kick off episode 21. Daisy Johnson. Oh, look at this. Now I think it's Daisy Johnson's turn. Daisy Johnson measuring Faith Connors. Oh! Never mind. Faith Connors. Connor with that right hand. That red glove right to the face. And now she's going to the top rope. And there's a moonstomp. The moonstomp. Here's the cover. Two. And this one's over. What a back and forth match this was between both ladies. But in the end, it was Faith Connors emerging victorious. There you see, that was the first moonstomp. Here's the rebound lariat. And then of course, this is like the first, I think, of five aftershocks Daisy Johnson tried using, but to no avail. And then of course, here was the moonstomp that finished off the matchup after she hit Daisy right in the face with that red glove.
Here is your winner, Faith Connors.
And Faith Connors gets the momentum for her team heading into Unbound. What an incredible matchup this was between both those ladies. Wait, what's going on here? Oh, well, wait a minute. Oh, come on. And now Faith Connors and Bo Dennis double teaming Daisy Johnson. Oh, there's Daisy trying to fight back, but Faith Connors, oh, now she's tying her up in the corner. Look at this, Bo Dennis just continuing to slap the face of Daisy Johnson and trash talking her while Faith has her tied up in the ropes. Absolute insult to injury right there. Oh, wait a minute, and now, what's Bo Dennis doing? Oh wait, Bo Dennis, the fade of black on a Daisy Johnson. Again, Daisy Johnson has been laid out by both Bo Dennis and Faith Connors. And you gotta wonder if Daisy having a tag team partner is gonna make things any different when they face off at Unbound. One can only hope so. Ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Now we're back, ladies and gentlemen. Wait, what is this? That's Batroc the Leaper and Batsui Jumanji and wait, what the hell? What the hell's going on here? The two are fighting in the back. Wait a minute! Batsu! GTS! Batsui Jumanji just laid out Batroc the Leaper with a GTS! Guess Bonsu's finally had enough of his crap.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Manchester, England, he is one half of MI-13, Union Jack.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, after what we just saw there between Batroc and Batsu, well, as you can see, one half of MI-13, Union Jack, is coming to the ring. Of course, in our last episode, we saw Union Jack's tag team partner, Captain Britain, go one-on-one with Bebop. Unfortunately, Captain Britain fell short in that matchup. Now it's Union Jack's turn, as he's set to go one-on-one with Bebop's tag team partner, Rocksteady, here tonight on episode 21. Jesus, ladies and gentlemen, as you just saw, Rocksteady filled up the entire screen. That's just how big he is. And you have to see him in person just to believe it. Well, in any case, ladies and gentlemen, as I mentioned before, Bebop was victorious over Captain Britain on our last episode. Now we're going to see if Rocksteady can continue the momentum for his team as the both teams head to face off against each other at Unbound in just a few weeks' time. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go. And look at this, Union Jack. I don't know how smart this is, taking the fight to the outside here. Look at this, Union Jack actually taking the fight to Rocksteady. As I mentioned before, both MI-13 and the team of Rocksteady and Bebop will face off against each other at Unbound, where the winner will become next in line for a shot at the UCWL Tag Team titles. Now look at this, though. Rocksteady countering into a side belly-to-belly suplex. Of course, the Tag Team champions currently are the Big Bang Theory. Of course, Leonard and Sheldon will be putting those belts on the line against Final Fight at Unbound. Now look at this, Union Jack sending Rocksteady back into the ring. I gotta give Union Jack credit. He is one tough competitor. He is not backing down from Rocksteady, despite giving up so much height and weight. Look at this. Here's the cover from Union Jack. Only a one count. You gotta wonder, though, how is Union Jack gonna be able to pin, or let alone defeat somebody? I mean, of course he just pinned the guy, but... Oh, look at this! Oh! Well... Headbutt there from Union Jack, and look at this! What the hell is this? Oh my god! Like a pump handle suplex! I thought Captain Britain was the strongest of the two MI-13 members. But Union Jack showing off some impressive strength as well. Rocksteady is no cruiserweight. And look at this. Backdrop suplex there from Union Jack. Look at this now. Union Jack sending Rocksteady into the ropes. But look at this. Rocksteady with a massive headbutt. And a huge shot to the throat. And just like that, Union Jack goes down. Look at this, though. Union Jack, though, back up. Running dropkick. Knocks Rocksteady to the ropes. Forearm strike. Oh, wait. Look at this. Rebound lariat. Change of what we just saw with Daisy Johnson and Faith Connors moments ago. And now, Rocksteady with the massive elbow. Here's the cover. Oh, look at that, though. Union Jack kicking out, not even one. As this capacity crowd trying to get behind Union Jack. Oh, wait, look at this. Rocksteady. Oh, that's a gore from a literal rhinoceros. Oh, wait a minute, what is this? Look at this, Captain Britain and Bebop. They're fighting in the back here. Captain Britain and Bebop, that's the gorilla position that they're fighting in. Oh, wait, look at this. Captain Britain with Bebop. Oh, my God. Alabama slam right through that table. It's distracted. Rocksteady bringing Union Jack to his feet. Oh, look at this. Oh! Omega driver. And now Rocksteady may be signaling for the end here. Rocksteady now. Look at this. Military press. Wait, Union Jack lands on his feet. And look at this. A cross arm breaker. A cross arm breaker on Rocksteady. Look at Union Jack cranking down on this arm breaker. He is hanging on to dear life to that arm. Rocksteady trying to fight it. But Union Jack continuing to apply even more pressure. Look at this at Union Jack. Look at this, he's got like a vice grip around that arm. And oh my God, he tapped out. Oh my God. Union Jack just made Rocksteady tap. I can't believe what we just witnessed. Union Jack made Rocksteady tap out to that cross arm breaker. Unfreaking believable. As we take a look at the action that took place during this matchup, I thought it was over after that Omega driver, but instead, Rocksteady went for that military press. Union Jack countered it into a cross arm breaker, would not let go of the arm until Rocksteady had no choice but to tap out.
Here is your winner by submission, Union Jack.
Unfriggin' believable. Union Jack gets the momentum for MI-13, heading into their match with Rocksteady and Bebop at Unbound. We'll be right back.
You are. going to reignite the era of wonder.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are live for the Royal Rumble.
Sheldon, you're still playing that game? You realize what time it is, right?
It is 10:46 p.m., Leonard.
Actually, it's almost 3 in the morning.
Yes, but it is only 10:46. Correction, 10:47 p.m. in Metro City.
Sheldon, Metro City's all the way on the other side of the country.
Yes, I'm aware of that.
Look, you've been at this game for hours now. Is something the matter?
Leonard, when we had our encounter with Cody and Guy back in Iowa, I came to the realization. I actually have never beaten Final Fight. So, I have made it my personal mission to beat this game and see what these two went through. Therefore, from a certain point of view, you can say, I have walked a mile in both Cody and Guy's shoes. Or in Guy's case, ninja boots.
And how has that been working out for you?
I'm still on level one.
Well, Sheldon, it's almost 3 in the morning here. Why don't you get some sleep and try again in the morning? That way we can get some time at the gym and get ready for our actual match against Final Fight and Unbound.
I'll get some sleep when my body starts to decompose after being stabbed several times by Mad Gear members.
Well, it seems like Sheldon Cooper is getting ready to defend the tag team titles in his own particular way. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, if you've been a member of the UCWL Facebook page, you will know that over the past few weeks, we have been seeing some vignettes centered around a new superstar coming to the UCWL roster, the self-proclaimed real Bruce Wayne, the founder of the Kino Body Workout Regiment named Gregory O'Gallagher. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I can say that right now what we have for you is his final vignette. Let's have a look at the newest member of the UCWL roster, Gregory O'Gallagher.
If you were to ask me a couple years ago what my life would be like today, I'd have a lot of answers, but this wouldn't be one of them. Do me a favor, imagine your life 3 months from now. Your day starts just like any other. You wake up, get out of bed, and head to the shower. Only before you get there, you catch your reflection in the mirror. You stop and take a step back. You're blown away. How would this one change affect your life? Feel it for a second. Imagine walking through life with unshakable confidence. Feeling incredible strength and power available at your fingertips. It's amazing how transforming your body can have such a profound effect on your entire life. I believe that one of the most significant things we can do in this life is to realize our full physical potential. You might think building such an incredible physique is a long, slow, torturous, and uncertain road. I used to think that too. I spent years understanding everything I could about dropping fat, building muscle, and developing an incredibly proportionate and attractive physique. It was my passion to master fitness. You know what I learned? Building an amazing body is a very simple, enjoyable process. A process the mainstream fitness industry wants to keep hidden from you to keep buying their next solution. Do you want to know the truth? Anyone, regardless of your genetics, your starting point, can build an amazing body. I've helped 150,000 people build incredible bodies they never thought possible using strategies that go completely against the grain. Reverse pyramid training to pack on crazy strength. Intermittent fasting to strip off fat. Focusing on those key lifts to build muscle like a Hollywood action star. Once you realize your full physical potential, your entire life will transform. Give it 3 months, I guarantee, and you will be blown away.
My name is Gregory O'Gallagher. It's time for you to unleash your potential.
That's right, ladies and gentlemen, we can confirm that Gregory O'Gallagher will make his long-awaited first appearance in UCWL in a few weeks' time when we head to his home country of Canada for Unbound. Well, ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere because coming up next is the highly anticipated finale of... Wait, what the... What the hell is this? Oh, wait a minute, that's Quiet and Code Talker. We were supposed to have the finale of the Elimination Chase coming up next, but it looks like we're being joined by Quiet and Code Talker. Of course, for the past several weeks, Code Talker has been demanding that Bindi Irwin accept a rematch against Quiet for Unbound. Except nobody has seen or heard from Bindi Irwin ever since Quiet took her out back on episode 18. And now it seems they're out here to hopefully try to get another response out of Bindi Irwin. I don't even know if Bindi's even here tonight. Like I said, she has not been seen since episode 18. And now it looks like Quiet's demanding a microphone for Code Talker. It looks like we're going to hear from him. Well, I definitely think that's a little bit of a stretch there from Code Talker. That is just completely and utterly disrespectful on the part of Code Talker, insulting. Oh, wait a minute. That's Bindi's music. Is she here? Is Bindi Irwin actually here tonight? She is, and she's got a microphone. All right, so it's official. Bindi Irwin versus Quiet and Unbound. Wait, what? She's not coming alone? What is she talking about? Well, wait a minute. That music. Oh my God. Are you kidding me? Is that? Oh my God, it is! That's Madison Lockhart from Destiny Championship Alliance! She's one of Bindi Irwin's trainers! And they're making a beeline to the ring! And Code Talker and Quiet are in retreat! Are you kidding me? DCA's Madison Lockhart is going to be in Bindi Irwin's corner for their match against Quiet and Unbound. We'll be right back.
Yeah! gonna do? What you gonna say when I wipe this smile right off of your face?
This next contest is the final match in the Elimination Chase to determine the number one contender for the UCWL Cyberspace Championship at Unbound, and is set for one fall.
Well, welcome back to episode 21 of UCWL, ladies and gentlemen. And if you're just joining us, he just missed one hell of a situation. It is confirmed we will see Bindi Irwin go one-on-one with Quiet at Unbound. And get this, Madison Lockhart from the Destiny Championship Alliance will be in Bindi Irwin's corner. What a match that should be, as there you see Chef Gordon Ramsay in the ring as we're getting set for the final match in the Elimination Chase.
From Tokyo, Japan, Kyo Kusanagi.
And there you see Chef Gordon Ramsay's opponent, Kyo Kusanagi, has come down to these two men, and only one of them is going to face Monkey D. Luffy for the Cyberspace Championship at Unbound. It's been a long road for these two, and now one of them is just one victory away from punching their ticket to Montreal, Quebec, Canada. Will it be Kyo Kusanagi or maybe Chef Gordon Ramsay? We're about to find out right now. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen. And here we go. The Elimination Chase finale is underway. Kyo Kusanagi starting off strong here with that half and half suplex. Or maybe it was a hatchet suplex. Kyo Kusanagi now bringing Ramsay to his feet though. Ramsay with the jawbreaker. And look at this. Float over into the neckbreaker. Of course, like I said, both these men are just one victory away from challenging Monkey D. Luffy for the UCWL Cyberspace Championship at Unbound. And you definitely know Luffy is going to be watching this matchup very closely to see who he will face in Montreal in just a few weeks' time. Now look at this, Gordon Ramsay with the head scissors followed by those elbows to the top of Kyo's head. Now look at this, Ramsay with the neck whip. Now look at this though, Kyo kicking Gordon Ramsay and now back to his feet. There's a shot to the midsection by Ramsay. Oh, look at that though, nice clothesline there by Kyo. But again, Ramsay trips the legs. And now, no, reversal. Down goes Gordon Ramsay. And look at that, Kyo with the running senton. Now Kyo off the ropes, and a second one. Off the ropes again. This time went for the axe handle, but missed. And there's a DDT from Ramsay. Leaping DDT by Chef Gordon Ramsay. You know he would definitely like to get the shot at Monkey D. Luffy. Look at this, off the ropes, no. Belly to back, belly to belly is reversed. Shot to the midsection there by Ramsay. And Gordon Ramsay hits the F word. That kneeling jawbreaker he calls the F word. And now, kick to the midsection. Gordon Ramsay, oh look at this! And there it is! The ride to Hell's Kitchen! The ride to Hell's Kitchen! And no! Kyo Kusanagi kicking out at two after the ride to Hell's Kitchen. And Gordon Ramsay can't believe it and is now heading to the top rope. Ramsay went for the elbow drop and he missed. Now it's Kyo Kusanagi. Second rope, went for the rolling senton and he missed that as well. Gordon Ramsay now turns him around. What's this? Backdrop suplex, dumping Kyo right on top of his head. Here's the cover by Ramsey. And look at that, only a one count. Only a one count. And Ramsey misses the drop kick. And look at this, it's Keo. Who's a doggy? Look at that, the combination strikes there. And now it's Keo. Bring Ramsey to his feet. Ramsey with a jawbreaker. Big drop kick. Look at the right hand there by Keo. Look at this, Keo Kusanagi. 75 Shiki Kai right to the face. We're gonna do it. Two. No. Gordon Ramsay kicks out at two, and he avoids the drop kick. And there's a 12-6 elbow to the top of Keo's head. And now Gordon Ramsay with the cover. And look at that again, it's only a one count. This goes to show you what a shot at the Cyberspace Championship means for both of these guys. And look at this, Ramsay with the neck breaker. And now Gordon Ramsay. Here we go again, another F word. The second F word in this matchup. But look at this. Keo blocks it with a jawbreaker. And a jumping tornado DDT. Here's the cover on Ramsey. Two. And no. Now look at this. Lifting reverse DDT there. Now look at this. Keo trying to go to work on the arm. Ramsey with the elbow to the face. Kick to the midsection. And there's another one. Right to Hell's Kitchen. Two. And no. Gordon Ramsay cannot believe it. He thought he had a three, but Keo kicked out in the last second. And now it's Keo Kusanagi. Release Tiger Suplex. And I think the back of Gordon Ramsay's head may have hit the turnbuckle. I'm not 100% sure. And now look at this. Keo setting up Gordon Ramsay for the 75 Shiki Kai. Is Keo Kusanagi gonna punch his ticket to Montreal? Two. And he does! What a match this was between both men. And in the end, it's the heir to the Kusanagi clan standing tall as we take a look at the action that took place throughout this matchup. We saw that backdrop suplex from Gordon Ramsay. Now that's the first 75 Shiki Kai, which did not get the pinfall victory at this point in time. But there you see the second one, right on the money. And with that 75 Shiki Kai, Keo Kusanagi has punched his ticket to Montreal, Quebec, Canada, and Unbound.
Here is your winner and new number one contender for the UCWL Cyberspace Championship, Keo Kusanagi.
And Keo Kusanagi has done it. He will face Monkey D. Luffy for the UCWL Cyberspace Championship at Unbound. What a match that was between both men. Oh, wait a minute. Speaking of Monkey D. Luffy, there he is. And he has the Cyberspace Championship with him. Look at this. Luffy entering the ring.
Oh, what a match that's going to be for the Cyberspace Championship at Unbound, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back. And ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to UCWL episode 21. And if you're just joining us, you just missed the Elimination Chase finale. As there you see Kyo Kusanagi hitting the 75 Shiki Kai right to the face of Chef Gordon Ramsay as he punches his ticket to Montreal, Quebec, Canada, and a shot at the Cyberspace Championship. And then there you see the champion, Monkey D. Luffy, entering the ring, having a quick stare down with his opponent at Unbound. And ladies and gentlemen, with Kyo Kusanagi's victory in the Elimination Chase moments ago, we can now confirm the Unbound card is now finalized and set as we are about to run down the complete Unbound card for you right now, starting with this match that was made earlier today. It'll be women's tag team action as Daisy Johnson and a partner of her choosing will face off against the dastardly duo of Bo Dennis and Faith Connors. Earlier tonight, Daisy went one-on-one with Faith Connors and the numbers game got the best of her again. Bo Dennis claims that it doesn't matter who Daisy picks to be her partner, that the end result will be the same.
Will Bull bring her proclamation to pass and her and Faith are victorious once again? Or will Daisy's partner be the all-that-important X-Factor in this match and take down this dangerous duo? Also in another grudge match, we will see the wielder of the Death Note, Light Yagami, go one-on-one with Keith Abicari. These two have been at each other's throats ever since Light Yagami cost Keith Abicari his match against PS Power back at Cold Day in Hell, with Light claiming that Keith Abicari is nothing more than a waste of space on the roster and looks to prove he is right when these two face off in Montreal. Will Yagami back up his claims, or will Keith Abicari dance all over Yagami's face in victory at Unbound? The UCWL Cruiser X Division Championship will be on the line for the first time ever at Unbound as champion Yaiba Kamikaze defends his title against the number one contender and the only man to pit him in singles competition, Hollywood Adonis Creed. We heard from both men earlier tonight, and both men seem poised and ready to lead Montreal with the title. Will Adonis forge his own legacy and become the new Cruiser X Division champion, or will the Cybernetic Ninja hang on to his coveted title? The number one contendership for the UCWL Tag Team Championships will be up for grabs as well at Unbound as MI-13, Captain Britain, and Union Jack face off against the Giant Mutant Tandem of Rocksteady and Bebop. Both teams have picked up singles victories over each these past few weeks. Now the question is, which team will use that momentum to their advantage and walk out of Montreal next in line for the tag team titles? Will it be Britain's Finest Heroes, or will it be the Shredder's Mutant Henchmen? After weeks of taunting and demanding, Quiet and Code Talker are finally going to get what they want, as it will be Quiet going one-on-one with Bindi Irwin in a rematch from the Queens of Wrestling Tournament qualifiers. Quiet will have the devious Code Talker in her corner, but Bindi isn't coming alone, as she will have DCA Wildcat Superstar and one of her trainers, Madison Lockhart, in her corner for her match at Unbound. Can Bindi Irwin show that her recent string of wins was not just luck and pick up another victory? Or will Quiet silence all of Bindi's supporters once and for all? With the dust finally settling on the elimination chase, only one man is left standing. Gio Kusanagi will get the biggest opportunity of his UCWL career when he faces off against Monkey D. Luffy with the UCWL Cyberspace Championship on the line. This match should be an epic encounter between two up-and-coming superstars in virtual wrestling. Will the heirs of the Kusanagi clan leave Montreal the new Cyberspace Champion? Or will the future King of the Pirates add another successful title defense to his already impressive title reign? The UCWL Tag Team Championships will be on the line for the first time as well, as the Big Bang Theory, Leonard Hofstadter, and Sheldon Cooper put those titles on the line against the team they defeated in the Tag Team Turmoil match at Cold Day in Hell to win those belts, Cody and Guy Final Fight. Will Leonard and Sheldon show the virtual wrestling world that their win at Cold Day in Hell was not a fluke and be able to retain their championships? Or will they be one and done and the saviors of Metro City leave Montreal as the new tag team champions? And then we have the main event for the UCWL Championship as reigning champion the Green Arrow defends his title in a triple threat match against both superstars who have been after his title for months, Nathan Explosion and Yuri Boyka. Despite Boyka's recent medical condition, he is still scheduled to participate in this match. Will the most complete fighter in the world walk out of Montreal as the new UCWL champion? Or perhaps it'll be Nathan Explosion's time to shine and he leaves Montreal as the new champion? Or will it be the Emerald Archer who adds another successful title defense to his reign as champion? Ladies and gentlemen, you do not want to miss UCWL's third ever mega event, Unbound, live from Montreal, Quebec, Canada, hopefully before the end of the year. Well, ladies and gentlemen, don't go anywhere, because speaking of the UCWL champion, the Green Arrow, he will be in action next. He takes on Light Yagami in a non-title match when UCWL returns.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is your main event of the evening. It is a non-title match and is set for one fall.
Welcome back to UCWL episode 21, ladies and gentlemen, as we are getting set for our main event, as here comes the wielder of the Death Note, Light Yagami, to the ring. As we just mentioned moments ago, Light Yagami will be in action at Unbound when he goes one-on-one with Keith Abicary. And of course, if he were to pick up a victory against his opponent here tonight, he would have huge momentum heading into that matchup. But his opponent is not just any other superstar. His opponent is the reigning and defending UCWL champion. And who knows, if he can somehow manage to get a victory here tonight, he could very well launch himself into the UCWL title picture. That is a big, big if though, as we now await Light Yagami's opponent. Listen to this ovation for the Emerald Archer, the reigning and defending UCWL champion, as he's set to defend that title in a triple threat match against both Nathan Explosion and Yuri Boyka at Unbound. And we'll get to the situation involving Yuri Boyka in just a moment, as we are set for our main event here tonight on episode 21. And there's the bell, ladies and gentlemen. Our main event is officially underway. And look at this. Light Yagami immediately chucking the UCWL champion to the outside. Well, as I mentioned before, Green Arrow is set to defend that title against both Nathan Explosion and Yuri Boyka. Well, look at that. Green Arrow escaping out of that chin lock. And there's a spinning heel kick, but I don't think he got all of it. But he did get all of that drop kick. There's so much action going on, I can't get what I want to say out. We still do not have any new medical updates on the condition of Yuri Boyka. Since episode 20, he is still scheduled to compete at Unbound. But we do not know what the medical condition of Yuri Boyka is after he got legitimately knocked out by Nathan Explosion back on episode 19. And he's back to this matchup now. Green Arrow, Irish Whip into the ropes. There's a sling blade onto Light Yagami. Of course, I also have to question Green Arrow taking this matchup so close to a very pivotal matchup. Look at that. No, Light Yagami lands on his feet. Back. Oh, look at that. No, backdrop suplex turned to a spine buster. And now Light Yagami going to the top rope. Dropping the elbow right into the chest of the UCWL champion. Right now, Green Arrow in a lot of trouble here. There's a vicious DDT there from Light Yagami. And of course, you gotta wonder if Yagami's opponent, Keith Abicari, is watching this matchup wherever he is. And look at that, nice counter there by Green Arrow into the back body drop. And look at that, Green Arrow springboard elbow right into the lower back of Light Yagami. But look at that, though, Yagami with the dragon screw. Here's the cover. And only a one count. Now look at this, Yagami going to work on the Green Arrow. Kick to the midsection though by Arrow. Is countered to an arm drag. But look at this. The Green Arrow not backing down. But again sent to the outside by the wielder of the Death Note. Now look at this. Light Yagami and the Green Arrow fighting in front of the Dutch announce team. And look at this though. Green Arrow though. Forearms to the face. And a huge flatliner. Green Arrow now. Look at this. Snapping the leg of Light Yagami. But look at that though. Light Yagami with a kick right to the face of the Green Arrow. Oh, down to the canvas goes Yagami, but Yagami fights back with a jawbreaker. Oh wait, we've seen Yagami do this before. That rope hung DDT. Excuse me. Oh wait a minute, he could be going for it. He could be setting up the Green Arrow for it. Oh, here it comes, the Death Note. The Death Note. Are you kidding me? Is Light Yagami going to pick up a victory here? No, he's not. Light Yagami cannot believe it. He almost picked up a victory over the UCWL champion. He almost launched himself into the title hunt. Now look at that. Knee drop right to the forehead up by the Green Arrow. And now Green Arrow measuring Light Yagami, shining wizard to the back of the head. Now look at this. Green Arrow trying to get the crowd rallied behind him. Picking up Light Yagami, and again, Light Yagami driving the shoulder of the champion into the canvas. He went for a cover, but couldn't even get a one count. And now, Light Yagami on the second rope, trying to measure the UCWL champion. Huge axe handle off the second rope there. And now, no, reversal by the Green Arrow. Shoulder block there. And now the Green Arrow, huge knee to the face. Green Arrow now, what is this? Oh, we've seen this before. A variation of the curb stomp. Oh, look at that, nice kick there from Light Yagami. Or it's been a very competitive back and forth match. between both of these men, and there you see the vicious Garvin stomp by Light Yagami, taking it to the UCWL champion, and he follows it up with that huge stomp onto the head of the Green Arrow, but Arrow fights back with that uppercut. Look at this! Rolls through with the schoolboy, follows it up with the super kick. And now Green Arrow, nope. Reversal by Yagami. Here's the cover. Two and no. Green Arrow kicks out at two. And now, Light Yagami. Again with the Green Arrow. Oh, wait, what is this? Oh, look at this! A rope-hung version of the Death Note! But instead of going for the cover, he wants to inflict more punishment. Yeah, see, I'm not sure if that was a smart idea by Light Yagami, as Green Arrow is able to counter with not one but two fireman's carries. And there's a dragon suplex with a bridge! Two and no! And now, oh! Nice counter there by Yagami with the arm drag. I gotta give credit where credit's due. Yagami with the Olympic slam. Here's the cover. Two and no. Like I said, I'm giving credit where credit's due. Light Yagami is bringing the fight to the Green Arrow here tonight. Green Arrow now. What's this? Oh, what a move by the Green Arrow. Backdrop suplex into a face buster. Light Yagami with a kick to the face. Floats over into the DDT. And now, look at this. Light Yagami with a triangle choke. Trying to get the UCWL champion to tap out. Well, look at this. Green Arrow, though, fights out of it. You cannot deny the heart and the toughness of the Green Arrow. Look at this. Green Arrow. Powerbomb hold. Into the cover. Two. And he turns it into the Boston Crab. But look at this. Light Yagami quickly escapes the hold. What a main event match this is between both of these men. Green Arrow now. Look at this. Half Nelson into the backbreaker. And now. Oh, we're going to see it. No. Oh, I thought he was going to go with the Queen's Gambit. Instead, he hits that single underhook suplex. And now. The Green Arrow. Huge knee to the face. To Light Yagami. And now driving the knee into the canvas. What a match this is between both of these men. Now stepping on the shoulder blade. Green Arrow now. Oh, now Light Yagami. And Green Arrow. Trading blows here. Green Arrow getting the best of Light Yagami. What? Wait a minute! What the? Nathan Explosion! Nathan Explosion from out of nowhere! And now he's assaulting the Green Arrow! Trying to hurt the Green Arrow before their triple threat match! And Unbound! And now Nathan Explosion with a steel chair to the UCWL champion! Nathan Explosion repeatedly. Oh, well, wait a minute! Wait a minute! Keith Abicary! Keith Abicary came in through the crowd while Light Yagami was distracted with what's going on between Nathan Explosion and the Green Arrow. And now, Keith Abicary trying to get him some of White Yagami. These two are going to face off one-on-one at Unbound, but if they don't want to wait until then. Look at Keith Avicari. Look at this, chucking White Yagami right into the barricade. Look at this, White Yagami continuing to go to work. Into the barricade goes Yagami. I've never seen Keith Avicari like this before. Oh, there's the Light Yagami now trying to fight back here. Now Yagami trying to escape. Oh! Had second thoughts about a huge clothesline. Oh, now he's trying to get away from Keith Avicari. Oh, look at this, Keith Avicari in pursuit! Keith Avicari and Light Yagami fighting through the crowd here. Keith Avicari and Light Yagami brawling throughout this capacity crowd here in Concord, New Hampshire. Oh, wait a minute. Meanwhile, Nathan Explosion has Green Arrow back in the ring. Oh, here we go. Nathan Explosion with the Metalocalypse to the UCWL champion. Oh, whoa, wait a minute! Oh my god, it's Yuri Boyka! Yuri Boyka! Look at that, out of nowhere with a tornado kick! Yuri Boyka's back! And he just laid out Nathan Explosion! Are we gonna see this sight in Unbound? Is the most complete fighter in the world gonna become our new UCWL champion? Ladies and gentlemen, that's all the time we have for you here tonight. We will see you all in Montreal, Quebec, Canada for Unbound!